Okay, here you see good. Rahul is good. You read it. You read it. Rahul is good. Here, the word good. Here, the word good qualifies or describes the noun Rahul. Is that it? Yes. And number two, in the second sentence, this house is ours. Here also, you can see the underlying word is this, and this points to the noun house, doesn't it? This points to the house. That means this describes, this definitely describes, this definitely points out the noun house. And in the third place, we bought a luxurious car yesterday. Here, this word qualifies car. This word qualifies car.
Yes.
Luxurious. We bought a luxurious car yesterday. Here, the word luxurious describes or qualifies the noun car. Isn't it? Or in the fourth place, he is rich. Here, the word rich. The word rich qualifies or describes the pronoun he. Okay? In this way, in the first sentence, you can see the word good qualifies or describes the noun Rahul, the subject of the sentence. In the second place, this points out the noun house. This points out, this point indicating word of the noun house. In this way, in the third place, we bought a luxurious car here. Luxurious, this word luxurious, this word luxurious describes or qualifies the noun car. And in the fourth place, he is rich. Here, the word rich qualifies or describes the pronoun he, the subject of the sentence. In this way, the words in italics above are all adjectives because they qualifies or describes the nouns. Okay? The words in italics above, italics means good, this, luxurious, rich, these four words are in italics. Above are all adjectives. Why are they adjectives? Why are they all adjectives? Because they describe or talk something about a noun or a pronoun. Okay? And goes to the next place. Here, more about adjectives. What are adjectives? Can you see? What are adjectives? Adjectives are qualifying words, as we discussed in the first sentences. Adjectives are qualifying words. They qualify a noun or a pronoun. And in short, we can see a word that qualifies or describes a noun or a pronoun is an adjective. Okay? A word that qualifies or describes a noun is called an adjective. Are you following me? Here, adjectives are qualifying words. They qualify a noun or a pronoun. Examples. Huidi is beautiful. Here, the subject is Huidi. And can you define, can you identify the word that describes the subject Huidi? Can you identify a word that qualifies Huidi? Beautiful, right? Huidi is beautiful here. The word beautiful describes or qualifies the subject Huidi. Huidi is the V is like broken down, okay? So this word qualifies the noun to be. That is why it's called. It is called what? And exactly. The word meaning. One is a predicate adjective. The another is an adjective. Right. The next phase. And another with a noun after it. Another with a noun after it. That means as an adjective. Okay. Pretty is beautiful. Here, the word beautiful is used as a compliment. Okay. Here, the bath is. It remains incomplete in meanings. So, in order to make its complete, its meaning complete, the word exactly beautiful is used. When beautiful is used, the meaning of a bath is becomes complete. Okay. Without beautiful, this as in this verb has no complete meaning. We can't say anything. Pretty is what pretty is. We can't say, but when we say beautiful, pretty is beautiful. We can say that pretty is beautiful. Pretty is. Now, it is when it is added with the adjective beautiful, the meaning becomes complete. So, as a compliment and predicates something about the subject. Predicative use of adjectives. Predicative. So, this kind of adjective is known as predicative use of adjectives. In the third place, the USA is a wealthy country. Here, the word wealthy is used with a noun and it qualifies the noun country after it. That comes after it. It describes the noun that follows after it. That comes after it. Such an adjective is called attributive use of adjectives. And I think you might have got some idea about adjective. He is an intelligent boy. You are also intelligent. Comes before the noun. It qualifies. Here the word intelligent is used attributively. It qualifies the noun boy following it or that comes after. Like this. We have two uses of adjectives. One is predicative use and another is attributive use. Okay? Come to the next. Kinds of adjectives. After knowing the use of adjectives in two ways, we can classify adjectives. Adjective has the following kinds, adjective of quality. An adjective which simply qualifies a person, place, thing or element is called an adjective of quality. That means adjective of quality, qualitative adjectives. It qualifies a noun. Simply for example, I believe this is qualifying adjective. And qualifying adjectives has its antonym. Antonym words also. If there is good, there is bad. Those words are here. Qualifying adjective or adjective qualities are those words. Adjective of quality. An adjective which simply qualifies a person, a place, a thing or an animal is called an adjective of quality. Example, Sila is wise. Here, wise is adjective. The word wise simply describes the subject Sila. So it is an adjective of quality. see, we can sort of say that something qualifies the hillside. Number three, can we play with us? It's an interesting story. Here, the word interesting is an adjective quality. It simply qualifies the long story of the interesting story. So, interesting, the word or adjective interesting qualifies the long story. Okay? And the adjective quality answers the question how or what part of the subject. Quiz like that. I am told here. Told is a word that qualifies time. Okay? Siam is four. Siam is four, but his friend is rich. Here, the word four qualifies he, and the word rich qualifies. There are so many words. So many words. Use as executive of quality, fair and only for stories of law. Good, 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 we have bad. Good, good, we have store. Good, red, enough money. Enough money. In our house, repair 1,000 a day, my father can earn 1,000 a day. That is